Good afternoon, guys. So in this class we are going to discuss about the mentioned topics under this agenda. Okay, this is what the topics we are going to discuss today. Okay, so as usual, before going to start this session, let me take a couple of minutes to recall the last session. Okay, in the last session we have discussed about various topics. In that, very first topic is about HTML marquee tag. Okay, we have discussed about how to add a marquee tag in our HTML web page. So in general, marquee is nothing but it is a scrolling piece of text displayed either horizontally across or vertically down on your web page. Okay, it all depends on your settings. Okay, so that is what we have discussed about the HTML marquee tag. Okay, in that we have seen some other attributes, right? Like width, how to give the marquee tag from the specified width. Okay, we have discussed about how to give the directions and how to give the behavior like slide and scroll. Okay, this is what the first topic is about. The second topic is about block level element. Okay, block level element is nothing but div tag. Okay, we have discussed about how to use a div tag and what is the use of that div tag. Okay, in general, what is this div tag is doing? It divides the HTML document into sections. Okay, it divides the HTML document into section wise. Okay, that is the main functionality behind this div tag. Okay, the third topic is about, we have discussed how to use a form in HTML. Okay, form is nothing but HTML forms are required if you want to collect some data from the site visitor. Site visitor is nothing but if a person is visiting your particular website, if you want to wish to get any input from the visitor, means we can use a tag saying form. Under this form, we have discussed about so many input types. Okay, like input type equal to text. So text, if you give input type equal to text, means it will give you a single line text, right? It allows you to enter your text there. Then the second one is about how to use radio button and how to insert a radio button in HTML pages. And we have discussed about how to use checkboxes in HTML. Okay, and we have discussed about input type equal to date also, how to give the date and how to insert the date text field in our HTML web page, and how to insert a number. Okay, in the number we have discussed additionally min and max attributes. Okay, min is nothing but it will stops you up to select the minimum value, and the maximum values is also it stops you the entered maximum value. Okay, if you are entered the minimum value as 1, means it will not allow to select below 1. Okay, if you are entered maximum value as 5, means it will not allow you to enter the greater than amount of that particular value. Okay, this is what we have discussed. And the last topic is about how to insert a button in our HTML page. That is what we have discussed. In that, we have discussed two different topics. One is input type equal to button, and the second one is button type equal to button. Okay, and additionally we have discussed about CSS property, display CSS property. Okay, in that we have discussed a property display and the value as block, and the second value is none. Okay, display colon block and display colon none. Okay, how to implement that and what is the functionality behind that particular property and the value. Okay, this is what so far we have discussed in the last session. Okay, in this today's session, as I mentioned, that is what we are going to discuss. Okay, so the first topic is about input type equal to email. Okay, how to give an input column email in our HTML page. Second one is reset. Okay, what is the functionalities of reset and how to use this input type equal to reset. Third one is input type equal to tell. Tell is nothing but telephone number, how to add a telephone number and how to validate that. Okay, then input type equal to submit. Okay, what is this submit and what is the functionalities of this submit and all we are going to discuss. Okay, and then drop down list in HTML, how to insert a drop down list in our HTML. And then the last before topic is HTML text area. Okay, text area is a tag. Okay, While explaining the coding part, I will explain you what is this text area is about. Okay, the last topic is design a button. Okay, in the last class we have discussed how to insert a button. Okay, here I am explaining how to design a button with colors and with styling properties, height, width, background color, text color, so and so. Okay, this is what the topics we are going to cover in the today's session. Okay, we'll move on to the coding part. So as usual, we are going to get the HTML structure here. Okay. First topic, how to give a input type equal to email. Okay. For that, what we need, the very first is about add a form. Okay. Inside this form, I'm adding input type equal to email. Okay, so before this, just I'm giving a label for my input type. So I'm just giving enter your email. Okay, and then let me give a break here. So that the next input type email text box will comes in the new line. Okay. Let me run this code. See, I got my input field. Okay, input type equal to email. Okay, let me align this if you are, that is not visible. Style equal to I got my label enter your email here. Okay, so this will be the text to enter your email. Okay, what is this functionality of input type email is, see, when you give input type equal to email means, what it does means, it allows, okay, it allows a user to enter the email ID there. Okay, it allows the user to enter email address with pattern validation. Okay, what is pattern validation here? Pattern validation is nothing but, okay, in general, we all know that how a email address will be, okay, the email address will be a set of alphabets and numerical values, okay, along with we have a default set of pattern. What is that? There should be a at symbol, right? At symbol at the end, it will end with .com. Okay, this is the general pattern of bar email address. Okay, there will be a set of alphanumeric values and followed by at symbol, and then there will be a .com. Okay, this is the pattern of our email ID, right? So when you enter this input type equal to email, okay, then what it does means, it creates an input field which allows us, or it allows a user to enter the email address with pattern validation. Okay, see, in the enter your email field, I am just given the ABCD only. Okay, I am not given any at and .com, right? So how this get validate means, okay, for that we need another set of input type here. Okay, that is nothing but, as I said in the agenda, it is, see, input type equal to submit. Okay, so what is this input type submit is, it defines a button. Okay, here input type equal to submit means, it gives you a button here. Okay, button. Okay, what it does means, it is for submitting the data. Okay, whatever the enter data, it will validate before submitting. Okay, it will validate the pattern. Okay, if you are giving this input type email and after that you are giving input type equal to submit means, when you click on the submit button, what it does means, it will gives you a message saying we are entered, or the entered text field is matching the pattern or not. Okay, this is the functionality of this submit button. Okay, see, I'm just refreshing. See, when I give input type equal to submit, it gives you a submit button here, right? So now I am entering an email ID. Just I am giving the ABCD. So when I click on submit, see, it is showing a error message, a beautiful error message saying, please include an @ in the email address. Okay. So it is asking to match the pattern. Okay. ABCD is missing an @ symbol. Okay, this is what the general email address format, right? So it is asking to enter email address. Okay, so I have entered the @ symbol there. Apart from this, what again it's saying? Please enter a part following @. ABCD @ is incomplete. Okay, see, let me show you again. Before entering @, what it says? It is said missing an @ symbol. Okay. When I enter @, again what it's saying, it is saying ABCD @ is incomplete. What is this incomplete is about? The next pattern is, as I said, there should be a .com, right? There should be a .com. See, for example, I'm giving gmail.com. So it is matched the required pattern @ and .com. If I click submit, means, see, it is gone, it is resetted, which means you have entered the valid pattern. Okay, it will check only the valid pattern when you click on this submit button. Okay, this is what the email address is about, how to add a email input field in our web page. Okay, the concept is very, very simple. Just I have used two different attributes. Okay, one is input type equal to email, and the second one is input type equal to submit. Okay, the submit, what it does means generally it validates the pattern, okay, with some backend process, with it will store in the database. The entered email address will stores in the database. Okay, this is how an email address will be inserted in our web page. Okay, so we'll move on to the next topic. Okay, the next topic is about how to give a drop down list in our HTML page. Okay, for that we need a tag. Okay, the tag is about select. Okay, the tag is about select. Okay, just let me give a label for my drop down list. Okay, let me give a break here. Okay, so I'm just giving the label saying choose your degree. Okay, choose your degree. Okay, this is the tag for inserting a drop down list. Okay, let me run this, what it is coming there. See, it will gives you a drop down list, right? Okay, when you click on this symbol, it will give you the list. Okay, here nothing is displayed. Okay, why means we have not inserted any list under this select tag. Okay, when I insert a select tag here, see, it is giving a small icon which is specifying a down, something like down arrow, right? When you click on that, okay, it is giving you a set of list. Okay, here list is not available, so that is what it is showing a empty there. Okay, so now what we are going to do, we are going to add the list. Okay, here the list is nothing but I am going to give the options for my list. Okay, option, first I am going to give select from the list. Okay, this will be the my first option. Let's see what it is coming. See, it gives you the select from the list. Okay, let me add some more options inside this. Okay, First, let me add something like B/BTech. Okay. So I'm just giving according to my label. Okay. My label is about what I have given, choose your degree, right? So just I am giving the degrees list here. Okay. M-Tech. Okay. So option BSc, okay, BSc/MSc, okay, this is enough. Okay, I have given three different options. Okay, one is select from the list, and the third, okay, the second and third, fourth, or just I have given the degrees options. Okay, let's see how it is replicated. See, I got my choose your degree label. I got my drop down list. Okay, see, when I click this, see, you got your degrees options or the degrees list, whatever you have mentioned. Okay, so when you click on this particular list, that will be selected as displayed here. Okay, so this is what, how to display a drop down list in our HTML page. Okay. So this is very simple. We are going to use a tag here. Okay, a tag saying select. Okay, inside that select, we are going to give the options. Okay, the options are followed by open tag and the closing tag. Okay, inside that we are giving the values options to my drop down list. Okay, so we'll see the next topic inside this select tag. Okay, what is that means? If you want to display the visible values, see the visible values, what it visibling, the first value it is displaying, right? So if you want to display on the screen load itself, if you want to display the first two options, okay, if you want to display the first two options in your page, means what we have to do means you have to give an attribute saying size. After this open tag select, you have to give size. See, I'm giving the size equal to 2. If you give the size means, see what it is replicating. See, it will show you the first two. Okay, on the screen load itself, it will show you the first two options. Okay. This is what the use of this size attribute. Okay, so if you are giving the size equal to 3 means it will display you the first three options on the screen load. Okay, similarly, if you are giving the 4 values means it will display all the 4 values there. Okay, it will display the all 4 values there. Okay, this is what the use of size attribute in the select tag. Okay, so then the drop down list is allowing us to select only single value, right? If you want to select multiple options, or if you want to allow your users to select multiple values in the particular drop down list, means that is also possible in HTML. Okay, so for that, what you have to do means we have to just insert an attribute saying, as I said, my term multiple. Okay, just give a attribute saying multiple. Okay, just give a attribute saying multiple. So what this does means, this multiple attribute will allow the user to select more than one value in our page. See, when you give the multiple attribute means the list will be like this only. Okay, see, just I'm removing the multiple, just I'm giving select. Okay, I'm not used any size here. Okay, so this is will be the list. Okay, in this list what it specifies, it allows only to select one value. Okay, when I use multiple attribute, see how your drop down list will be. See, the drop down list will be it will give all the options in a single box. Okay, it will gives you the all values in single box where you can select multiple values here. Okay, see, you can drag the two options, or you can use click and control option. See, click and press control button and select rest of three options. See, it allows you to select multiple values in your drop down. Okay, this is the main functionality behind this multiple attributes. Okay, hope you guys are able to understand right what is this single selection and what is this multiple selection. Okay, if you give select alone means it will gives you to allow for selecting one value or one option in your drop down list. Okay, if you give multiple as your attribute in your select tag, okay, what it does, it allows you to select more than one value. Okay, this is what how to insert a drop down list in our HTML, right? So we'll move on to the next topic. Okay, the next topic is about reset. Okay, input type equal to reset. Okay, for that just I am creating a input fields. Okay, label I am just giving first name, okay. So I am giving a input field here. Okay, to enter a first name, what we need an input type equal to text. Okay, just I am creating two input fields here. Okay, one is first name, another one is last name. Okay, let me create another one. Okay, just I am creating you to understand the input type equal to reset option here. Okay, so something like address. Okay, just I am giving this options. Okay, see how it is replicated there. Let me give a break here. See, what I have done is I have created three input fields. Okay, one is first name, last name and address. Okay, after this what I am doing, I'm just giving a input type equal to reset. Okay, so let me command all those things here, don't confuse this. See, so here also the input type result, okay, is about a button. So this is also giving you a button like input type equal to submit. If you have entered right, input type equal to submit means what it gives, it shows you a button. Okay, similarly this input type equal to reset is also a button. Okay, what is this main functionality means? The input type reset is defined as a button. Okay, as I said, it is defined as a button. But what is this button is doing here means when the user performs this click event, okay, when the user is clicking on the reset button means, okay, by default it erase or it reset all the inputted values. Okay, what it does, it reset or it erase or it deletes the all inputted values in the particular form. Okay, see, in this form right now I am using three different text field. One is first name, second one is last name and the third one is address. Okay, at last what I have done, I have given input type equal to reset. Okay, this gives you a button there. Okay, so let me type something here. Okay, first name I am typing as ABCD. Okay, address I am just giving XYZ. Okay, I have entered all the input fields in the form. Okay, I have entered all the input fields. See, when you click on the reset button, see, I clicked on the reset button. What it does, it removes, okay, it resetted all the input values into a fresh text fields. Okay, let me do that again. See, I'm entering first name as ABCD, the last name is EFGH, okay, IJKL. Okay, see, I have entered. If you click on this reset button, it will reset all your text fields under inside this or under this form. Okay, this is what the functionality, the main functionality behind this reset input type. Okay, let me repeat you again. The input type reset is also defined as a button as input type equal to submit. Okay, but when the user performs this action, like clicking on the reset button, by default what it does means it will reset the all the entered inputted field in your web page. Okay, this is what the main functionality behind this reset input type. Okay, hope you guys are able to understand what is this. Okay, so we'll move on to the next topic. Okay, the next topic is about text area. Okay, so as I said in the beginning, text area is a tag in HTML. Okay, text area is a tag in HTML. Okay, let me give a label for my text area. Okay, so my label is about, so for example, explain about you. Okay, for this what I am doing, instead of, see, explain about you means what we have to do, we have to explain about ourselves. Okay, like introduce yourself. If you are using input type equal to text here means, okay, what it does means it will give you only a single line here, right? It will gives you a single line here, isn't it? See, it is giving you a single line, right? So while explaining about self, this single line will not sufficient. Okay, the look and feel will not be sufficient. Okay, for this only, what we are doing, instead of this input type equal to text, we are using a tag saying text area. Okay, if you are using text area means, see, what it gives? It gives you a multiple line text. Okay, it gives you a multiple lines of text. Okay, hope you guys are able to understand what is this input type equal to text and the text area. Okay, input type text equal to text, it will gives you a single line field. Okay, whereas this text area will gives you the multiple lines. Okay, you can handle this also by using rows and columns. Okay, by using rows and columns attribute. See, if you give the call equal to 5 means, see, it will allows only for this 5 column, it will adjust only for 5 columns. Okay, meanwhile you can give the rows also, rows equal to 8. I am giving 8. See, it is just increasing the height and width. Okay, it is just like increasing the height and width. Okay, let me give the calls also 8. Okay, this is how you can handle the calls and rows. Okay, or if you want only the rows, means you can just give the rows equal to 8. Okay, it will gives you to enter about 8 rows. Okay, up to entering 8 rows, it will adjust your text area. Okay, similarly, you can give whatever the rows you want. You can just give 15 also. What it gives means it gives you a 15 rows of text box. Okay, this is what the text area field is about. Okay, input type text equal, let me repeat it again, input type equal to text will give you a single line field. Okay, this text area will give you multiple lines of text field. Okay, you can handle the text field by using rows and columns attributes. Okay, if you give rows, you can specify the rows. Okay, for that particular specification, your text area will be replicated there. Okay, this is what, how to insert a text area in our HTML field. Okay, so hope you guys are able to understand this. Okay, so the next topic we are going to discuss about some attributes in our input types. Okay, some other attributes in our input types. Okay, see, what does this attribute means? As we are using rows, we are using size. Okay, see here in the options, we are used select, after select we have used size, right? In the number field, we have used min equal to 5, max equal to 5. Okay, that is all the attributes for your input types. Okay, already I have explained you about min attributes, max attributes, okay, size attribute. Okay, in the text area field, I have explained you about rows attributes, calls attributes, right? So similarly, let me explain you some other attributes in this text input type fields. Okay, so in that, first thing what I am doing means I am giving a attribute saying read only. Okay, read only means it will, what is the main functionality behind this read only means, it will not allow you to edit anything in your text field. Okay, how? See, just I am giving the values, sorry, just I'm giving you the value for my text area. Okay, something like okay, don't confuse, let me explain the read only concept. See, in my text area, let me remove this rows also. Okay, what I have given, I've given a value saying explain about you. What it does, absolutely, this explain about you will replicate in your text area, right? It will comes here. Okay, so okay, let me remove this and I will explain you on the input type equal to text. Input type equal to text. Okay, I'm giving value as my name. See what it gives in the input type text, what it doing, I have mentioned a value saying my name. Okay, it is displaying as the default value here. Okay, what you have to do, you can remove this and you can add whatever you want the content here. Okay, so if you are using the read only attribute, means what it does means you can just see that value there inside the text field. Okay, see, I am not able to delete or I am not able to add anything in my text field. Okay, it will allows you only to read the content in your text field. Okay, so whatever the value you can okay, so whatever the text you have given inside this value attribute, that will be replicated in your text. When you insert the read only attribute, what it does means you can just read that. Okay, just you can see the text field with the value. Okay, whereas you are not able to edit or delete whatever inside the text field. Okay, this is what the read only attribute. Okay, this is what the read only attribute. Okay, the second one is, let me give it as my name. Okay, the second attribute is about, see, I'm just replicating the same. Okay, I'm using an attribute saying, okay, disabled. Okay, disabled. Okay, this is an attribute for input type, for our input types. Okay, let's see what it is happening. Okay, let me, I have given a break, right? Yes, see what is does. In the read only attribute, you can just select the content. Okay, you can just double click on the text, so we can do some operations, okay, like selecting, or you can copy that and paste somewhere, right? So whereas this disabled field is, see, it is showing in a gray box. Okay, we are not able to do anything with that. Okay, so can you see the difference between the normal text box and the disabled text box? See, when I remove this disabled, see, so you are able to edit. Okay, so whereas if you give a disabled field means, see, you are not able to point your cursor also. Okay, see, it is showing in a gray color background, which means it is a disabled field. Okay, this is also similarly like read only option. Okay, so when you use this disabled for a button, okay, for a button input type button equal to, you have given some button. Okay, if you give this disabled means, you are not able to perform anything. Okay, when you click on that button, it will not happen anything. It will doesn't show any actions. Like, see, just I'm giving input type equal to button. Okay, I'm giving input type equal to button, and the value for the button is submit. See, got a submit button here, right? So when you give disabled means, see, a button is there. Okay, input type button equal to a submit button is there, but you will not able to click anything there. Okay, see, it will be like idle. Okay, you will not do anything with that button. Okay, when you remove this disabled, see, it's showing some actions that you are clicking on the button, right? So this is what the disabled attribute and input type. Okay, so hope you guys are able to understand what is this attributes all about in all about in our HTML. Okay, so we'll move on to the next attribute. Okay, let me go to this drop down list. Okay, so I have given a drop down list here, right? So here what we are going to do means, so in the drop down list we have three options, right? We are having three options. Okay, if you want to select any particular value by default in your web page, okay, if you want to see, I am given BE, BTech, ME, MTech, BSc, MSc, right? So in this, you want to give any particular value should be selected in the web page means what you have to do means after this option, okay, after this option what you have to give means you have to give an attribute saying selected. Okay, in my web page what I am going to do, by default what it is showing, the first option is displaying in our web page, right? See, let me remove this and show you. See, in the what is the first option? Select from the list, right? Select from the list is my first option, so it is displaying here. Okay, when I use selected attribute in a particular option means what it does means, see, it will by default it will selecting the particular option. Okay, where I have given the selected attribute here for my second option, for BE BTech I have given selected. Okay, when you refresh your screen it will show you by default BE BTech as your selected value. Okay, this is called attribute selected. Okay, this is only we are using in the drop down list. Similarly, wherever you want you can use that. That particular option will be in the top of your drop down list, or it will shown as that you are selected. See, and now I have given the selected attribute to your BSc MSc option. Okay, so it is showing that BSc MSc is selected here. Okay, this is what the selected attribute in input types. Okay, the selected attributes most probably we are going to use only in this drop down list. Okay, so hope you guys are able to understand. So far we have discussed what is read only attribute, what is disabled attribute, what is selected attribute. Okay, so we'll move on to the next attribute. Okay, the next attribute is about required. Okay, required is nothing but, as I said in the beginning, required is what, if you want any field to be mandatory filled or it should be compulsorily filled means, okay, we have to use a field saying, an attribute saying required. Okay, for example, I'm just using input type equal to text. Okay, input type equal to text. So let me give a label here. Okay, okay, see, I have given first name. Okay, after that what I am doing, input type equal to submit. Okay, so what I am doing means in the input type first name, okay, my label for my input type text equal to first name, isn't it? So what I am doing, I am making this as a compulsory field while you are submitting your page. For that what you have to do means you have to use attribute saying required. Okay, what happens means when you click on submit, okay, it will shows you that this field is mandatory, you have to fill this field. Okay, if you want any symbols means we can use using some other CSS properties. Okay, we have to use some other CSS properties and we have to add a symbol here. Okay, so if you are mentioned as required means what it does means it will shows you a error message. See, please fill out this field. Okay, which means you have to fill this field. Okay, similarly you can add n number of fields. Okay. For example, I'm giving this last name and I'm giving address. Okay. So I'm giving address and first name as required field in my form. Okay. See, I have created three text fields. Okay. One is first name, last name, and address. Okay. So here for my first name label, I'm using required. For my address label, I'm giving required. Okay. See, when you click, it will show you the first name as a mandatory. Okay. I'm giving ABC. Okay, then if you click on the next means, it will show you this address field is mandatory. Please fill it out. Okay, if you are giving multiple required means, what it does means, if you are not filling anything, directly you are clicking submit means, it will start in the first required field. Okay, first required field is first name. Okay, I have entered. Okay, just I am giving submit. Okay. And then address is the required field here. So you have to type some content in your address text box. Okay, this is how the required field is about. Okay, hope you guys were able to understand what is this required. Okay, so far we have discussed four different attributes for our input types. Okay, one is disabled. Okay, this is disabled attribute, and the second one is read only. And the third one is selected, and fourth one is required. Okay, this is the attributes for our input type fields. Okay, so we'll discuss the next input type. Okay, the next input type is about how to add a phone number field in our text box. Okay, for that, as I said, what will be the input type? Input type equal to tell. Okay, input type equal to tell. Okay, so let me add a label. Enter your phone number. Okay, I have given a label saying enter your phone number. Okay, so I have given input type equal to tell. Okay, see, we got our enter your phone number field. Okay, so along with this input type, we have to add an important attribute here. The attribute is about, so generally phone number is about 10 digit number. Okay, the phone number will be 10 digits. Okay, so we have to specify here. Okay, how to specify here means we have to use an attribute saying pattern. Okay, what is this pattern means? In this telephone number field, if you are trying to get only 10 digit number, means we have to give the patterns. Okay, the pattern is about a set bracket and a flower bracket. Okay, see, first I am using a set bracket. So inside this, what you have to do means, okay, obviously numbers will be from 0 to 9. Okay, so I am saying you have to enter from 0 to 9. Okay, this is what I mentioned in the square bracket, or this is a set bracket. Okay, so next what we have to do means we have to use a curly braces. Okay, inside this what we are mentioning means we are mentioning how many digits you want to fill in this particular input type. Okay, for that what I am doing, I'm just giving 10. Okay, what it does means It will allows you to enter 10 digit of number in your input field. Okay, let's see. See, just I'm entering 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, I have entered 11 digits here. Okay, how to validate this? As you all know, you have to give a submit button there. Okay, to understand, just I am giving a submit button. See, when I click the submit button after entering the 11 digit number, see, it is showing please match the requested format. Okay, what is the requested format here? We are asking to enter from 0 to 9. Okay, 0 to 9, the numbers are specified here. Okay, what is next we have mentioned? We have mentioned 10. So it is having 11 digits of number. Okay, so that is what, when I click on the submit, it is showing please match the requested format, which means it is asking to enter only 10 digits. Similarly, how many digits you want here to enter means you can give that digits. If you want 5, okay, that is also possible. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, see, I have entered 6 digits, so it is showing me the error. Okay, so this is what the how to enter the phone number. Okay, the phone number field will be entered using input type equal to tell. Okay, along with that, we are using a pattern here. So pattern is nothing but in this set bracket, we are mentioning that this field should contain only numbers. Okay, see what happens if you enter any alphabets. So if you enter any alphabets also, it will shows you please match the requested format. So what is the requested format? We are saying only please enter 0 to 9. Okay, so if you are not entering the numerical values, means instead of that, if you are specifying any alphabets here, means it will show you the submit. Okay, it also shows not only set of alphabets. If you are using 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, A means that will also show you the error. Okay, so what is the requested format now? 10. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 0. I have given 10 digits. We are giving additionally by mistake A means that is also not accepted because you have added an alphabet inside your text field. Okay, so this is how to insert a phone number field in our web page and how to validate that field. Okay, for that we are using pattern. In that pattern, we are using two set of elements. One is we have to specifying only this field should contain numerical values, nothing else. The numerical values will be 0 to 1. You have to enter the numbers from 0 to 9. Okay, then we are restricting to select only or to enter only 10 digit of numerical values from 0 to 9. Okay, this is what the pattern attribute defines in this input type equal to tell field. Okay, hope you guys are able to understand this. Okay, so we'll move on to the last topic of this session. Okay, the last topic is about how to design. Okay, yesterday I have showed you how to give a button. Okay, input type equal to button. Okay, okay, input type equal to button, and the value for the button is about, okay, save. Okay, it is giving you the save button here, right? So how to add the style properties? Okay, it is very simple. Okay, just use style attribute. Okay, so if you want to increase the width of your button, means just give style equal to width equal to, okay, if you want to increase the height of your button, just give height as 100 pixels. Okay, see, it is, so 100 it's very big, right? So give it as 50. So you can increase the width also. Okay, this is colon, sorry, So you can increase the height and width of your button. So if you want any color of button color, means what you have to give background so something aqua, so it will give you the beautiful color to your button. Okay, so this is what how to insert a background color. So if you want the text color, means just simply you can mention color. What it does, it gives you the color of your value. Okay, see, can change that color of your value. So what is the value here? Save as my value. If you give the color, okay, that is replicated as your color in your field. Okay, similarly you can add whatever the styling properties you want for your buttons. Okay, this is very very simple. So similarly you can add n number of buttons to your page. See, I'm just saving as submit, cancel, delete. See, let me give this color as black. This is how to implement the style properties for your buttons. Okay, you can give the color, height, width in your own choices also. Okay, this is how about add the style properties to your buttons. Okay, hope you guys able to understand. So for what are the things we have discussed. Okay, so I wanted to tell you one thing. So this is, see, the codes are present here, the above codes are present here, right? So it is not replicating in the screen, right? So what I have done is I have just commented that line. Okay, so see, this is all about how to comment your HTML code. Okay, see, if you just select that particular line and click on control slash button, okay, it will change the text into full green color, followed by a open angular bracket exclamatory symbol hyphen hyphen. Okay, what that it means, okay, it will comment your line. Okay, which means it will not take that particular line to execute in your document. See, the first button is gone because I have commented that. Okay, so similarly again, if you want to select that particular second line or second button, it should not display in your page, means just again click on control slash. Okay, the line will be commented and that part of line will not take for execution of your code. Okay, so later when you want, you can just again go on, select that particular line, again click on control slash. Okay, it will enable your code. Okay, so that again you will get your code executed back. Okay, this is what I am performed in the above line. So that is what it is not replicated, and the explaining part only I make visible here. So it is replicating in our screen. Okay, this is what about today's session. Hope you guys are able to understand. Okay, please try all this input types and how to color this, create multiple buttons in your pages and give the styling properties. Okay, try it with your own coding, right? Okay, see you guys. Thank you so much.